What's going on, Rochester? It's your host, E.
And Shawny. And you are now tuned in to the one and only 585 Report,
where we are building up the 585 by having constructive conversations while shedding light on what's going on in and around the town. So without further wait,
let's get into it. Make sure y'all like and tune in on social media platforms. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at the 585 Report. If you are not on social media, link us on the TuneIn app on 100.9 WXIR Extreme Independent Radio. Let go.
So every time I do that intro, I feel like I say I want to change the
all
intro.
All the time.
And we never change it. We got to get rid of that intro. And we got to do something else.
February recess, that can be our break. I mean, that can be our to-do list.
Yes, because I'm over it. And I always get tripped up by the while shedding light on. Because I'm saying on so many times. This was Bishop's intro. Shout out to Bishop. Hey, hope you're doing well. So I am excited.
I'm excited.
Because we have my friends in the building. Chanel, how are you, girl?
Best friend. I'm good. I'm happy to be here.
Oh, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So we wanted to get you on because I know, you were doing Shambands. So yes. We wanted to get the scoop on Shambands. So, you know, of course, we're friends on Instagram. So I had to, you know, go stalk a little bit and look in your bio. So it reads, owner of Shambands Luxury Accessories, mom, model, media girl. Talk to us about all of those roles
media
that you got
girl.
Going on.
Yes, media girl. I need to get back up on my media too, really. But yes, I recently started Shambands. It's just a line of headbands. Well, it started out as headbands, but now I've like moved on to like a whole bunch of other accessories, earrings, necklaces, hair clips. I have some other stuff in the works too. That's why I've been on a little pause because I'm getting creative behind the scenes. But yes, there's definitely some more things in store for Shambands for sure.
Nice.
Yes.
So we'll talk about. Wait, hold on. She didn't even address the mom and the model part and the media girl. Let's talk about all that stuff.
Yes, I am a mom. I'm pretty sure everybody that follows me on Instagram knows Dakota because I'm always posting him. Yes,
twin.
He is 7 now. I'm gonna say he's 6, but I'm like I can't even take it. But yes, 7, the big 7. So that's the mom part. And then media. Recently, I joined a show called The Kickback Radio Show on WAYO. So recently, like, we've been on a break, like, due to COVID, but hopefully we'll be picking back up on different things. But I also used to do, like, a Wine Wednesday thing, just, like, on my Instagram Live, just, like, talking about, like, what was going on, like, during the week, current events, whatever.
Doing it all.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Thank you.
That's really exciting. How do you where do you categorize and departmentalize everything?
I feel like right now, actually due to COVID, I've been relaxing a lot and it kind of feels bad because I feel lazy. But like before, I feel like I was doing like so much.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess now I'm trying to figure out, like, what am I, like, really passionate about? I was literally just talking to you about this at my... I had a little pink dinner, like, last week,
she
right?
She has these
I have themes. These random theme dinners, like, where my friends, I just bring us all together because, like, we don't see each other for a while. I'm like, mm-hmm. I feel like it's my responsibility for us to, like,
to
see
come
each
together.
Other. So we had a pink theme. It was so cute, but we always get deep in conversation whenever we start drinking.
They just bring it up.
But that's the best way to go, though.
Right.
So we were talking, and I was telling her, like, I feel like I don't necessarily know for sure, like, right now exactly what I want to do. I feel like I'm kind of a bit of a Jill of all trades, but I want to make sure that I master one of them. So I'm just trying to, like, hone in on some talents, maybe see, like, what's best fit for me. Because, I mean, of course, we all want to be successful.
Right.
So it's nice to have, like, hobbies, but I want to, like, really make sure that one of them is, like, driving me. So that's kind of where I'm at right now.
I love it. I love it. I feel like I was like at a point, and I don't know, I feel like we all can kind of relate to that at some point. Like, it's like, okay, I know I can be the jack of all trades, or like, what am I really passionate about? Like, what is it that I want to focus in on and say, this is what I'm passionate about. This doesn't feel like a job. But then I have these 10 million other things that, you know, bring some kind of satisfaction as well.
Yeah. You were just talking about that, Shawny.
I was.
You talk about it.
We're on the same wavelength.
No, for real. I'm like, I don't know if it's a Gemini thing where we just get bored with things and we want to move on. But then, like, also hearing you, I'm like, no, it's just a human thing.
Yeah. And your mind is just, like, everywhere. And you have, like, all these ideas. Like, oh, I know I can do this, so I'm going to do it. Like,
I think the good thing about it, though, I think it's a blessing to just have so many different gifts, right? Yes. Because it's like, okay, I can do so much, you know, even with the TV show. Like, that is huge. That is really huge. Mm-hmm. But to have these gifts, and it's like, okay, I have all of this, and it brings me joy, but I want just one thing that I want to focus on. So I definitely think that, like, kudos to you. That's awesome. What prompted you to start Shan Bands? I don't know. When I hear, like, Shan Bands, like, bands that make their dance.
Yeah. And the S is literally a money sign. So it's crazy because I actually got – I wasn't doing anything during COVID after March because I do – I plan weddings, really. Okay. So, like, I work for the Hyatt.
That needs to be on your resume.
Yeah. So, like, I'm a meeting connections manager, which is more than just weddings. But, like, I always say I plan weddings because that was my favorite thing that I was doing there. So, we had a pause due to COVID. You know, events were limited. So, I really was just staying at home and, like, obviously enjoying the time, like, with Dakota and different things. But I was, like, dating, kind of. And I actually was inspired by the person that I was seeing at that time. Mm-hmm. Like, it was kind of like a, you know, you should really start your own business. Like, and I was like, no, I'm not an entrepreneur. Like, I know what I want to do. And I feel like it's okay that I want to work for someone because the job that I'm doing, it still feels personal. So, like, I don't feel like I'm, like, punching this hard clock. Like, I have to do 9 to 5, but I feel like I'm fulfilled doing it. I'm not unhappy. So, I'm like, I don't know. What am I going to do? Like, I'm not gonna make clothes. Like, I don't know about that. I'm not gonna do this. I'm just saying, like, all this stuff I'm not gonna do. Mm-hmm. So then I'm like,
limiting yourself, girl.
I literally bought a headband from another girl and it was so pretty, and I'm like, oh my god, like, I love this. So I put it on, and the picture that I posted went like crazy on Facebook. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay, here's me in this headband. Maybe I should buy some headbands. So I just ordered some, and I literally sold out in a day. Like,
wow.
Yeah, it was crazy. I didn't expect it to be like that, but it did happen like that. Wow. So I was like, all right, this is easy. I don't really have to do too much. Like, I'm already on my phone, I'm scrolling. Now I'm just scrolling looking for more merchandise, like, at the same time. So I'm like, okay, this is cool. So boom, the name was just easy. Chanel, Shan. Some of my friends call me Shan. So I'm like, all right, Shan Bands, like, let's just throw it together and see, like, what happens.
I had a ring to it.
So yeah.
I like the part where you said that, okay, you're not an entrepreneur. That's what's in your head.
Yes.
Because I know so many people, like, throw that out there, like, you need to own your own business and ownership and all of that. But that's all about self-awareness and knowing yourself. Like, you were like, maybe not.
Yeah.
But then you came across something. You was like, okay, maybe. Mm-hmm. It's an option. It's a possibility. So that was dope.
I feel like it would have been something that I was passionate about, because I feel like, again, I don't think I would want to do something that made me feel like I was doing, like, too much additional work. Like, because I'm at this point, I'm like, I'm chilling, I kind of like it, I don't know, like, how I feel about it. But then I'm like, okay, this could be a thing. Like, this could really be a thing. And it was. So I don't know.
So talk to us about some of your products. What were you selling, and what do you plan to sell?
So people really go crazy for the designer headbands. So, like, I was able to get, like, the Gucci headbands, Dior headbands, Louis Vuitton, and then it was, like, I had, like, different kind of, like, puffy ones, like, and then some of them had, like, different prints, and some of them had stones. Really, I kind of try to follow, like, the trends, like, the people who sell clothes. Like, I kind of go on, I see what, like, I'm finding, like, on Instagram and stuff, and then I try to get some of that stuff that I see, like, in the search bars. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't as hard as I thought it would be, but definitely the designer bands, people go crazy for them.
Okay.
That's, like, the top seller. The Gucci band was Gucci sold band. Out. That one was the one that would sell out so fast. I couldn't even, it was pre-orders, too. I couldn't even hold on to them.
So what type of people order, like, the Gucci bands or all of that?
Everybody. I had, like, people, like, that my mom was friends with asking me for them, and then like people our age asking for them. Like it was, there was no limit.
That's what's up.
They just liked the print.
I feel like there's like different like eras where they're like, you know, in style. Like headbands was like in style back then, then it kind of went away, then it came back. Like the overalls was in style back then, went away, then it came back.
Everything's
like a trend.
Just feels full circle.
Yeah. So it's just kind of finding like what is staying on trend. But there's a lot that you could literally do with headbands because now there are wigs.
Oh yeah.
So it's like I'm cooking up some stuff. Cause I'm like always paying attention. And it sometimes it takes a while and people don't understand like when you take a break. Mm-hmm. But it's like I'm taking a break because like I have a bunch of stuff that I'm trying to do. And I wanna expand more than just headbands. Like I wanna have, that's why I said luxury accessories. Like people went crazy for the bags too. I started getting the matching headband and bags. I have like one left, I think. Like people loved them. So yeah, it's cool, it's nice. And I meet a lot of people too that way.
So you were talking about trends. So what trends are you like really crazy about right now?
Like outside of the headbands?
Yeah.
Oh, anything. So this print, like this hunter print, I don't know like what it is, but I think it's so cute. Like, and I feel like it goes with everything. Like I feel like it looks good with like pink and then like whatever color you accessorize it with. Like I really, really want a tennis skirt too. Ooh. Like those Nike ones that people have been wearing. Like I really envision myself in one like in the summertime.
The pleated ones?
Yeah, they're so cute and they're so classic. Like I want some of those.
So I see like Shan bands like just like expanding beyond accessories.
Yeah, all my friends are like, can you get a website? I'm like, I will this year. I promise you I will. But yeah, it's been cool though.
So, I'll go ahead.
So on the other side of that, what are some looks that you just see and you're like, hated it?
Let me think.
I know for me it's the big sneakers.
Like the chunky trainer ones?
Oh, I love them.
But you know why? I like them when I do bottle service because we wear sneakers, but they look like something else. They don't give me that flat, like, sneaker vibe. Because, you know, I don't really wear sneakers. So I'm like, when I do look for a sneaker, I do want, like, a chunky sneaker because it looks better to me like in that environment because I'm not
into other people but not me
into, like,
but I
heels,
think
like anything
I sneaker, like them too
boots.
I'm trying to think, oh what is that, it's like a two-piece but the material is like spongy. I don't know if you've seen it but to me it's I can't stand it and I keep seeing it everywhere and I feel like they sell out fast in boutiques. And I'm like why is it selling? I don't understand. It reminds me of something you would like wear in the hospital. Like I don't like it.
I'm not a fan of it's the big sneakers for me.
Yeah.
But I feel like the sneakers, I don't think I could actually purchase for myself. Like the boots I can, but the sneakers, you know how like they're cute or like this looks cute in you, but it won't look cute in me. Like,
yeah.
Those sneakers, that's how I feel. Like they're cute, but I don't think they look right at me. So I don't think I'll purchase them.
Yeah.
But he's like, no, I don't like them at all.
No, because, and this with all other people, they're fine.
Right.
But it's me because I have the skinny legs and I have big feet. So it just does
not. Right, so that's what I'm saying. Like, one of those where, like, it looks right on you, but it won't look right on me.
Yeah, I totally get that.
Yeah. Who is Shanel following on social media that draws inspiration?
You know what's weird? Like, I'm probably going to sound like one of those people that, like, what do they call it? Like, pick-me's or whatever. Okay. I don't care to, you know what I'm talking about? Okay, I don't really care to follow, like, a lot of celebrities because I'm just not, like, I feel like I'm not, I don't like to get, like, overly involved in their lives because I don't like to,
this
I don't,
me.
I don't stand people. I'm, like, I think it's weird. Mm-hmm. So, I'm just, like, There's, like, people that are, like, famous on Insta, like, models, I guess, that I like a few of them, but they're just regular people. Like, I'm not really, like, obsessed with. If that makes sense.
Okay.
Like, no, sometimes I like the stuff that, like, Kylie will wear because, like, when she gets, like, extra creative and, like, puts a color wig and a outfit, it's, like, something you do when you have money. Like, for me, like, oh, that's fun because I can see myself doing that in a photo shoot.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, maybe, I guess, like, a lot of people like Saweetie right now, too. She's cute. Like, she does fun stuff. Like, for me, like, the photo shoots I like are fun. Like, Young Miami, her birthday was today from City Girls. Mm-hmm. She did a cute photo shoot. Like, she looked like a Barbie. Like, stuff like that is fun. But I don't really, I can't really say, like, oh, this person I'm always, like,
yeah, I'm the same way with social media. I do not follow celebrities. I follow Beyonce, Meek Mill, Diddy.
I don't even follow them.
Yeah, I don't even follow them.
I go on her page sometimes, but
make sure the lights go back up.
Okay.
I go on her page sometimes, but I'm really not like I'm not a stan of anyone.
Oh, Beyonce. I won't say a stan. I'm just saying like I've been a fan for you know, since she's been out, and I like her new Ivy Park.
Yeah, it's very cute. Yeah. But you know what's also for me why I'm like that is because I feel like people shove people down your throat a lot, and it kind of makes you like not want to like see it for a while because it's like over and over and over again. I'm like that with music too. When people keep talking about something, I do not want to listen to it because now I'm like annoyed.
Yeah.
So I have to listen to it months later, and then I'm like, oh, I love this album, and you're like, you're late, and I'm like, well, I'm enjoying it. So whatever.
No, yeah, but I follow a lot of
the comparison to people's lives. So I know I can get big into that sometimes. So that's why, like, oh, this person is doing this, and I should be doing this. So that's why.
I don't like that either. Because people get so wrapped up into it, and then like the relationship goals and all that.
Yeah. I always
tell people my only relationship goals are literally my grandparents. They've literally been married 51 years, a real relationship that I've witnessed for 28 years of my life. That I know is not perfect, but is actually working. Right. And they literally just moved away from Rochester after 40 years, built a house from the ground up.
Wow.
In their 70s, and they're literally living their best life. Okay, that's relationship.
Right.
Not Birkins and all that. Like, let's be real.
And that's one of the reasons why I don't really follow a lot of celebrities. Like, I follow inspirational people because I'm just like the mindfulness queen. Like, social workers, advocates, like motivational speakers, like local people, but that's doing something that can inspire me like in different ways. I don't really care about the celebrities because that's a whole different lifestyle. Like,
you can't wrap yourself up into that because that's not realistic
at all.
I just think about students and kids and teenagers who, you know, social media just opens up so much to them, and then you see them trying to like emulate that lifestyle,
and it's like
even TikTok. I had a student, I'm like, he came into class today, and I'm like, well, where you been? Miss, I was at home sleeping. Miss, I was on TikTok. He's like, Miss, I got 10 million followers. And I said, I need you to put that energy into like school.
Right.
And like, he showed me his TikTok and he's popping on TikTok. But it's like social media, like what happened to your attention? And
nothing, because people literally see that you don't have to like
do much.
And like, even though it's weird, because like I feel that way too. Like, I did go away to school. Like, I went away to Hampton University, but I did not finish school yet. And like, I've went to school since then, but like, I'm still like, I'm like a year and a half left of school, and it's just like that year is just like, are you gonna do it?
Yeah.
Are you gonna do it? It's like a showdown between like me and the year. I don't know. But like, at the end of the day, I've also been extremely blessed to like have a great career for the past 5 years. I was in the same career and just continuously moved up to like great levels without finishing. But like, I'm never gonna like tell my son like, you don't have to go to school. You know what I mean? Like, school's a great avenue. You should try it. At least try it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because now people see, like, you could blow up. You don't have to go to school. You can have 10,000 views or whatever without doing anything. Like, and you can get monetized off that
media,
too now.
Like, and I get it. You definitely can. But it's like, okay, what happens when that's not there anymore?
Yeah, you got to realize like, stuff's trendy.
Basically. Right. Basically.
All right. So, what can people expect from you? What's next?
That's a great question. Definitely more products for sure. Like, I'm gonna stick with Shambands. I have an issue with like starting a lot of stuff and like not finishing it, but I love it. I think about it all the time. I'm always like looking up stuff, saving stuff, putting stuff in my cart, trying to move forward with additional things. And then also Dakota, he's into media too, and it's so cute because he asked me to start a food blog.
That's all you need to
do. So we're working on that now, and like hopefully we'll be releasing that in like March. So he's like really into like bizarre food with like Andrew Zimmern on like the Food Channel. We watch Chopped, like
that's
all that.
So cute.
And his dad actually cooks for a living. So we are always like, he was like raised in the kitchen basically. Mm-hmm. So it's so cute, and I'm like happy to have that too, because that's like something else I can focus on and like get him started into something constructive early, because girl, those games are driving me crazy.
Right.
And I can't even be mad because I'm like, this is literally the Fortnite. I'm like, what is this? I don't understand.
It's not asking for V-Bucks, okay?
And it's not, I don't think it's gonna stop.
at all.
It's been too long.
So, Shan, where can people find you on social media?
My Instagram is where I'm at the most, and that's like at the model blogger. I would say just Instagram, really, because there's really nowhere else. I don't really go anywhere. Oh, Twitter, at the model blogger.
You have a Twitter? I do understand Twitter.
At the model blogger. Twitter is so funny to me. Like, Twitter is like the pick-me-up that you didn't know you needed sometimes, because I don't go on it a lot. Mm-hmm. And I also don't have notifications for any app that I have. I don't have notifications for Instagram, for Facebook, for Messenger.
I don't. Notifications for Cash App.
I don't even have that either. I don't. It's so crazy. It's so crazy because I had got paid one time after I did. I do bottle service too. That's another thing.
Shout out Extreme.
I'm always in right. But literally, I got paid one time and I didn't even know. I'm like, oh, where did this come from? Like, oh, it's lit. Maybe I should turn the notifications on.
Right.
But yeah, I don't like to get like wrapped up in like stuff like that. So I usually will just check it sparingly. But I swear, I go on there and I'm dying laughing. Like, the stuff on there is so funny.
We had a good Twitter.
It's like the dark
web. We have a Twitter.
Whoops. It's like the dark web, but safe. Like, the stuff you didn't know you needed is on Twitter.
Girl. We don't be on Twitter.
It's funny.
So everything just, you know, goes through Instagram and it goes to Facebook and Twitter. All right, we're going to take a quick break. Thank you for that interview.
Yes.
And next we're going to get into the couch and some other things. You're tuned in to 100.9 WXIRS, the 585 report.
It's the only radio I rock. Remember, girl, I was the one that you gave you your first kiss. Cause I remember, girl, I was the one who said, put your lips like this. Even before all the feeling people screaming your name, girl, I was there. And you were my baby. It started with me.
Costly investment because you have to literally get multiple pairs and it takes a long time for shipping, so it's like you gotta have like at least two of every size. But they have some, literally I found so many vendors, it's crazy. I hope so. I'm trying to spend all of that, but my eyes on the place.
If you're just tuning in, make sure you run it back. We had the interview with Miss Chanel. Discussing Shan bands.
Shan's make her band. How should I say it? Shan's make her dance. Bands make her dance. I'm gonna try it later. But that definitely has a ring to it.
Yes, with some of the promo.
I'm gonna need that, okay?
Got you.
So we're gonna get into this couch. And usually we have a male perspective, but since
it's all about us, woman empowerment.
Exactly.
People want to hear what the man got to say.
Oh my gosh, I can't.
So since it's about friendship, I feel like that's close to our hearts. I feel like, I don't know, women take friendship way more seriously.
They do. I was literally just
so passionate.
Venting on my Instagram late today.
I think it's because, when you have friendships, you allow yourself to be vulnerable. Mm-hmm. And for some of us, we just don't do that with anybody.
Right.
So if I let you in and you like kind of betray me, like to me that hits higher. Mm-hmm. So that's why I was never one to just like befriend a whole bunch of women, because I just felt like it was a lot of messiness. But I feel like my tribe and the people that I've surrounded myself with now are very solid. So I'm very happy about that. The couch. All right, so this is a social media post that I saw. mind your business when it comes to your friend and her new love interest. Mm. As a friend, a lot of times we can see the manipulative tactics, the mind games, the game playing he's doing to our friend. But you better not tell her that, especially when she's blindly and desperately looking for love or are in love.
Not desperately.
Mind your business or she'll label you as anything but a friend, trying to make her aware of his BS. I don't emotionally invest myself into my friends' relationships. I don't like when my friends get emotionally invested into mine. Having boundaries and knowing the repercussions of not having your friends and your business is essential. All right, let's talk about
it. Sis been hurt, and she don't trust people, and she had a bad experience with a friend that she tried to probably look out for, and this is her perception.
But a lot of people think that way, though. Like, you would be, well, probably not even surprised, because a lot of times I feel like women will tell you, like, don't tell her anything because she's going to say you're hating on her, which is true. Some people really do feel that way.
I feel like this is, in my perception, if I consider you my friend, I got to have those real conversations with you, and you have to respect these real conversations. And the way I look at it, I can't call you my friend, but I'm tiptoeing around certain subjects or topics. Like, that's not, Chance, I'm looking at my nails. I got to get my nails done.
What do you, not see the rock on the other hand? Like,
oh, wait.
I'm like, sorry, caught my eye real quick.
I broke my nail, and then I got to get my nails. I'm going tomorrow, y'all. I thought she had looked down. I'm like, Chance, stop.
I was like, no.
You don't talk about that in my segment.
But I'm not for a shot. I promise.
Oh, you definitely thought about me because this nail been messed up since last week. I was just waiting for something so I can get it polished. But anyways, I'm sidetracked. But I do feel like, though, honestly, like as friends, though, but I do think that at some point in a friendship, you know, if you do see a friend where you feel like she's not going to listen, then I do think I have made those decisions before. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to let her be. If I had the conversation already, I'm not going to keep having
that conversation. Doing it again.
You know what I mean? Yeah. However, if it's the first time and I noticed it, I'm going to say something because you're my friend. Like, I love you. I feel like I'm not a true friend if I don't have that conversation. Like, I'm fake.
Yeah.
I'm fake. That's just the way I feel and the way I look at it.
Yeah.
So I absolutely agree. If you're my friend, people always say it's levels to it. So, if you're just an associate and I'm aware that your man is not any good, okay, you be great. You know,
I'm not gonna do that.
But right. If it's my friend, like, absolutely I'm going to say something.
Right.
I know I've had a situation where it happened to me and my friend didn't say anything and she had been, like, hurt before. She had said something, even provided pictures of the guy out with another girl. And she lost that friendship as a result of that. So, you know, that was like kind of the baggage that she carried. So she said she doesn't get involved anymore. And so I understand that. But if I call you my friend, I have to say something.
Yeah.
Whether you take the advice or not. But a lot of times I don't get involved with matters of the heart. And let me tell you why. Because at the end of the day, we're going to do what we want to do.
Absolutely.
We're going to do. The heart wants what it wants. And when you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, you'll be done. I can just say, you know, how I feel and then I'll move on to it. I'm not going to continue to stick with it.
I do think that it also plays a part of, like, age. Because a lot of younger friendships, like, with younger women is very, like, still rooted in, like, pettiness and stuff. So, and it's like you haven't experienced the growth to know that, like, you should probably be, like, listening to your friend a little bit because everybody isn't hating on you. Some people genuinely do care about you. And I have, like, a really good friend that she had to, like, put me on to some stuff, like, last year or whatever. And at first, it kind of was just like, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, I've like, reviewed everything, and I'm like, she's never, like, you know, ever did anything or gave me these vibes. So it's like, no, like, as a friend, like, I should be able to tell you, you should be able to tell me. If you're, as long as you're telling me, like, in the right way, and it's not, like, any malice behind it. But, yeah, a lot of younger friendships, they can't handle it.
Yeah.
It's just, like, we're too young to, like, wrap your head around it.
Yeah, and I feel like even when she said like she's blindly and desperately looking for love, like I don't like that, because I feel like, and I'm just gonna speak for me, I've been in a place even before my husband and I got married, like we were dating since we were teenagers, there's been times where I was blind, but it's like at the same time as my friend, you just let me be, like don't consider me desperate.
Yeah, see, it's like, a little shady a little bit.
You see what I'm saying? But I feel like, and I don't know, this is just my own opinion, I feel like we all have probably been in a situation where maybe we've stayed a little too long, yeah, or you know, we should have left, but right, we needed to go through that experience in order to learn and grow from that experience or that relationship. Yeah. So like, she's, I don't like that desperate word, because I've heard it before, like, oh, she's just desperate. She's
but then again, it. Sometimes people really are, have a bit of desperation. And and it's like, sometimes it's not healthy, and sometimes you do need to check your friend, like, that's look, true, you're doing a little bit too much. We're friends. I don't want you to get hurt, and I also don't want you to be embarrassed, because people, sometimes people start talking, and it's like, dang, this is my friend, like, I don't want her going out bad, like, right, you know?
So especially just, with the internet.
Yeah, especially in the age of the internet.
Do y'all remember that group that exposed people? It was like a whole group.
But they still do, they're still, there was many versions of that after that big one. But yeah, like, Lord have mercy.
I feel like they come out like every like 6
couple
months.
Couple years. Like, or a couple years. It'll be a big one every couple
it's
years.
It's gotta be another one pretty soon.
I don't even understand stuff like that either. It's just like, you're this upset that you're literally about to put somebody on blast. Exposing like, people. Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah,
like,
I think that's corny.
For me, especially when men do it, I'm just like, and not to be like sexist or anything, but like, it just drives me to another level of like, wow, this man was really thought hurt to like go out here and like,
right,
do this.
Right. But you know what I wanted to touch on too, and you mentioned this, Shan. I feel like sometimes men can like build a barrier with women, where it's like, now we think that like we can't have these conversations because he's gonna turn her against me, and you know, things like that. And I feel like that's where some of this statement or this experience come in at, because there has been men that will turn their friend against their friend. They're like, oh, she's hating, oh, she want me.
Yeah, you, they tell you like, that all the time. They do. They'll be like, oh, I don't know why, whatever, whole time they probably was in her box, like, you don't right, even know the truth, right, like, or something crazy like that. It's like they try to pin you against them.
Yeah,
yeah, I've seen it.
And it's unfortunate, because I do feel like as women we need to stick more together, you know what I mean? It's like, okay, if she's telling me this again, she care about me, blah blah blah, and not thinking all the time that she's hating or yeah, whatever.
Especially if they never gave you a reason to like feel like they were hating
right,
on you.
And that's the important part, because we have to know what their intent is and what mm-hmm, what their heart is. We have to know their true intentions. And if it's my friend, I know that their true intentions will never be to hurt me.
Right. That's the difference. Because anybody, no one random should be like, anyways, like coming to, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wouldn't be a random like situation. And if it is, it's like, okay. Yeah. But like, if this is someone you literally talk to, mm-hmm, you know, all the time or whatever. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, so that was the couch.
The couch.
All right, now we're going to get into some news. And I'm kind of excited about this, because that means the world is starting to open up.
It's opening up, y'all. I'm like, Hercules.
No, for real, though. It's hard. It's hard being a millennial in this type of environment.
For real.
All right, Cuomo is allowing large stadiums, large arenas, and stadiums to be open once again, February 23rd.
That's what,
a week and a half? Yes, that is very close. Yes, I was thinking about all the events and concerts that will allow to be back. Yeah. I guess he felt like the whole Buffalo Bills thing was a success.
And then, hello, the Super Bowl. Like, how are we literally not allowed to do stuff when they're having an entire Super Bowl? Like, it just kind of feels very contradictory to me. Like,
and kids are still not in school, but that's another thing.
Yeah.
And, but yeah, so.
I'm ready for church, too. Anybody else?
I need to get back in church.
Sorry.
Yeah. The Father's House opened up briefly, and then it closed back down again. So, yeah, I do enjoy.
I'm definitely ready for a little church.
My time. But, yeah, so we'll be able to enjoy concerts and things again. The Barclays Center is going to be the first venue to open up.
Nice.
So that's that. Rochester City School District, did y'all see the people that are going crazy because...
The school lunch.
School lunch.
Mm-hmm.
So I have... I don't want to sound like a person of privilege, and so that's why I kind of move away from the topic, because yeah, I've never, I kids always brought their lunch to school because same. Of the income requirements. They never had school lunch. However, right now, people are getting food stamps like crazy because, I guess because kids are staying home, they've increased. Mm-hmm. So I'm just upset why people are mad about it. If you're so upset, send your kid with the lunch. Like, I understand that the quality isn't that great, but when has the quality ever been great?
I guess they were upset because it was cold every day or something.
Yes, yeah, the cold lunch. Send your kid with the lunch.
Yeah, and guess what? My kid, he literally, his lunch that he brings from home is cold too because all he eats is ham sandwiches. But he just wants a ham sandwich from home instead. Yeah. But it's funny.
I feel both sides. Like, I feel, and I do think, and this is nothing against you because my kids are the same way. When they're in person, they bring lunches to school. Yeah. But it is a privilege. At the end of the day, it is a privilege, yeah. Right? But there are some students that they don't have that privilege. It's a luxury, basically, to me. And that's why I tell my kids all the time, like, you and my son will pack a lunch and come home and the food's still in there. I'm like, oh, girl, you're just wasting food. Like, you know that is a privilege.
Two bites out of this. What are you doing?
And they get the snack and the Capri Sun.
Yes, the Capri Sun's always on. Yes.
But it is a privilege. However, there are students that can't afford it. Like, yeah. They can't afford to bring lunch. However, this is the other side.
Woo!
And then this is the other side. There's students who may not have that privilege and still don't eat the school lunch. Like, I literally will have to, like, have conversations with my students every morning for breakfast and for lunch. Eat breakfast. I don't want to eat that. They don't eat. They don't eat. So, this right here, I found this, like, really? Mm-hmm. Students come to school and they just choose because it's nasty. So, it has nothing to do with, well, maybe cold. But even if it was hot, they still don't eat it.
Or they'll go to the corner store before school. Fill up on snacks, and they'll eat that.
Yeah, the hot Cheetos, the Takis, the Brisk. Like, they come with all of that, and that's it. They don't eat the lunch.
That used to be me, though. I'm not even going to lie. My mom, though, I used to have, I was such a weird child. I used to eat, like, specific things, but, like, all the time, nonstop, but the same stuff. So I would always have a box of Lucky Charms in my locker, a box of Slim Jims, and, like, some other thing. Yeah, I would literally have the box, like, at the top. Because my mom knew, she's like, yeah, she's not going to eat anything. Like, that's just what she's going to eat. Yeah.
So they laid off a lot of people, and hours were cut from 40 to 22 of all the individuals who did food service. So that's one reason why students are getting hot lunches. So, I mean, this, of course, it went crazy on the internet, and they're looking into ways to include hot lunches for students. But right now, they're saying that the city school district just was not prepared for students to come back to school. They don't think they were prepared in the way that they should have been.
But that's the thing. Like, I wish parents will understand, and if you're listening, your child comes to school and do not eat lunch. Like, even if it is hot, they choose not to eat lunch.
I see it.
But I get it. You know, you want to put it in the city, and this is how you feel. Like, that's you're welcome to feel that way. But when they're hot meals, and the pizza be looking good, especially when I be hungry and I got a salad and they sitting up there not eating it or just take a bite and toss it. Like, kids are, these are like 2021 kids. Like, they're different. They just, when we were hungry, we ate, and we weren't
afraid. I just saw a Facebook post about this today. It was like 2021 parent. I made pot roast, and like, you tell the kid to come eat it, and the kid's like, I don't want that. Then it's like 1996, mom. Like, I made this pot roast. Y'all better come eat it. Exactly. I don't want it. Then you're going to be hungry.
Exactly.
Unfortunately, I have turned into the 2021 mom, and my kid is little, but he's still so just ridiculously, like, privileged, spoiled, used to stuff, like, whatever. Like, only in Rochester do six-year-olds ask for crab legs and steak and Chipotle.
Okay, Dakota.
So, back to the crab legs. And that's what somebody I saw post on Facebook that said, y'all can skip a couple crab leg dinners and send y'all kids with lunches to school.
Ooh. Right. Some parents are giving their kids crab legs and packing lunch. Me. So, like, no, but seriously, though. Because I literally witnessed, overheard a conversation of, I forgot where I was, but someone was like, oh, yeah, I make good stuff for myself, but I give my kids chicken nuggets every night. I'm just like, what type of, what in the world? Like, not make good stuff for myself. Like, listen, I'm gonna cook what I want to eat, and you can feel free to eat that as well. I'm not gonna make you have a hot dog every night.
Right. Now, I do wish I had that 1990 whatever of my mom, because like we fared that. Like, my mom would not play, and the kitchen was closed at a certain time.
Yes.
My kids now.
My mom did not do that. My mom never did that, and that's why I do that with Dakota, because I'm used to it. My mom would make 3 different dinners.
I think that's why I'm such a
She would be like, what do you guys want? You want this? You want this? This? Mm-hmm.
This is what she made. No.
She never used to do that.
And you better do that by 7 o'clock.
That's your main.
Oh my gosh.
She makes the girls different things, and I'd be like, okay.
Yeah. But I think that's why now I'm such a like system person, because that's how I was growing up. Like, the house had to be cleaned by 10 o'clock. We needed to be brushed. Our teeth needed to be brushed, hair brushed, comb. Even if we didn't have nowhere to go, we needed to be up
and ready. I'm all good for a routine. That's the only thing I feel like I do bend on is like food. Because I feel like, what's the point of me making you eat the food if you truly don't like it? Like, my money's going to waste. And you're still gonna be hungry.
I am ready in broccoli. Like, you know how when you get ready to throw
up. And I love
broccoli. See, I love broccoli. My mom used to make like shrimp pasta and like make it look fancy. So I always like fancy stuff. Mm. So that's how I got into it. She's like,
see, I grew up, it was 10 of us. So like, we didn't eat.
10 siblings?
Yeah. Well, it was like in the same household, we probably had a max of like 7 or 8.
Okay.
But like, I have a total of 9 siblings.
Oh my gosh.
So it was a lot. So we didn't eat for nutrition. We ate to basically get full. Like, you couldn't get healthy or eat healthy food. Like, you're gonna eat this, and that's what it is. I gotta feed all of y'all.
Right. And it's different. Like, I only have one. Like, so it's like, okay, it's me and you. I want this, you want that. Like,
that's true. All right, so this is something, let's see. So this is something that I was very excited about, that Bello names the first ever chief of diversity for Monroe County, and she's a Black woman.
Yes, have you met her?
So no, I just, social media.
She's super sweet, I've met her before.
Deanna Kimbrough.
Yeah.
And it's, first of all, it's dope that, you know, our county has this position. But it's dope that it's a Black woman.
Yeah, it is.
She said it's an absolute honor to join Monroe County as the first chief diversity officer. My sentiments, much like those of Vice President Harris, I may be the first, but I will not be the last.
Okay.
Period. I was like,
all right. Come in with a statement.
She is. Oh, that was very heartwarming. So she has a doctorate.
Yep, sure does. She be post. Listen, I follow her on Facebook. She be flexing. Okay,
really?
She deserves to. Yes, she does. She gonna let you know, and that's right. You better let us know. That's amazing.
All right. So last thing I want to talk about, because it's kind of messy. Ooh. Lauren London shuts down pregnancy rumor.
Yeah, it is messy.
So when people came on social media, like, I was very, like, annoyed by these men who feel like she can't move on with her life.
First of all, it's always sexist vibes for me, because just somebody compared it to when they had the Meg rumors and stuff, and they automatically assumed Meg was lying with no proof, but they automatically assumed that she was pregnant with no proof. Why is it like that? Like, why is it like that?
And why did they trash her like that?
Exactly. First of all, it's been 2 years, right? I'm sorry, is she never supposed to be happy again?
Right.
People are widows and literally meet someone in 6 months, and she's so classy, like, I just can't with people.
Yeah.
Even if she did get pregnant, I feel like it would have been a situation where she was in another relationship, actually in love with someone. Like, she doesn't give me messy vibes, you know?
Mm-hmm. All right, so that is our local and national news. We're gonna take a quick break, and we'll come back with Shameless Shawny.
Shameless Shawny.
Shawny, I be loving you in your segments. When you did Gemini.
I'm like, look at this little foolishness. Just straight ghetto, okay? I don't even know why I did it. I think I was like looking up, like, oh, I forgot I had this necklace. So that was from Naya's little boutique.
Gemini.
Nobody at all.
But it's not.
we are back. Thank you for tuning in. We about to have Shameless Shawny. And I love this. We good. All right, so I love her intro, so let's hear it.
All right.
You hear this beat, you already know what time it is, all right? It's your girl, Shameless Shawny. This segment will be brought to you weekly, shamelessly exploring real life conversations, topics, scenarios, and or quotes related to woman empowerment. So make sure you stay locked and tuned in to receive some empowering, inspirational messages, all right? All shamelessly.
Period. All right, y'all, happy Lover's Day. So, in honor of February 14th, self-love, as we talked about last week, this is our self-love journey. We can love everyone else, we can love our significant others, our partners, whatever, but what is it? We gotta love ourselves. We have to love ourselves first, all right? Self-love. Keep notes of the times that you feel you're most confident, the people that make you smile and laugh until your stomach hurts, and the moments that you were incredibly challenging but you were thankful for, or you're thankful for. At those moments, no matter how hard they were, led you to the person you are today. You see, self-love isn't about loving yourself and everything that happens to you all the time, but instead about truly growing through the hard stuff, even when they were the last thing you wanted to do. Being painfully honest with yourself is unconditional love. So today and beyond, we will say no. So today and beyond, we will say no when we used to say yes to protect our peace. We are choosing to put our goals at the top of our priorities because we deserve to reach them. We are starting to trust ourselves every day as we are keeping the promises we make to ourselves. We are forgiving ourselves. Forgiveness is key on this self-love journey. So like forgiving yourself for anything, any experience, anything that you have said yes to in the past, anything that you have allowed in the past, forgive yourself and let it go. We are no longer allowing others to control our emotions and actions. And this means ending relationships, okay? Mm-hmm. This has nothing to do with anyone else. This doesn't have, even for me, this has nothing to do with my husband, my children, my friends. Like, this has nothing to do with any of them. This is all for me. This is all for me. This is all for you. But no, we are doing this for us, okay? I am doing this for me. You are doing this for you. Happy self-love day. Shameless Shawny.
Aw, Shawny. That was just so touching.
Yeah.
I think, so it's even harder now that, you know, I got so many things going on to make that time for self-love. But I have to force it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I really have to force it. So that's an important reminder.
Absolutely. And I just want to say this too, and to everyone, whoever's listening, like, it really is a reminder. Like, it's a daily reminder for me, especially for someone who is selfless. It's hard. I feel like even as moms, like, how do we be selfish? How do you be selfish, and how do you really put that time in for you? Being in a relationship, how do you say no even to your partner when they're demanding or they want this time? But it's like really just learning how to say no and being okay with that. Right. And being selfish for you. Selfish to be self-love.
All right.
Or to have self-love.
And that was Shameless Shawny.
Hey, yo.
We're going to get into this segment, Who Knows Our Guest Best. We're going to do... Not all of them. We're going to do a few of them so we can still have time for some other thing. So, you got to give us a point, whoever gets the answer right.
Okay.
Okay. Would you rather be a member of the Kardashian family or a member of the Obama family?
Ooh. Did I do this last time? I'm going to say Obama because I'm trying to get this together.
Yep.
Okay.
Thank God you guys know. Definitely not.
All right, piercing or tattoos? I'm gonna say tattoos.
I'm going piercings.
Tattoos.
Ooh. You know her though, so this don't even count. Like.
These are still pretty good though.
Leather or lace?
That's a hard one.
I say lace.
I say leather. I feel like she's like in between.
I am though, but so like both. I'll give it both because honestly, like,
I definitely feel like she's in between.
It's a vibe.
All right. Ability to fly or ability to read minds?
Ooh, I'm gonna go with read minds.
I say read minds.
For sure.
Blonde or redhead? Blonde.
Red.
Red.
Ooh. I think you purposely. You said that on purpose.
Matching or mismatched socks? I say matching.
I'd say matching too.
No.
Mismatched?
I don't even know where one pair of socks is.
Well, that's the same for me.
I'll probably die. Like, if someone was like, find a pair of socks now, or you're really? Done, I'll be like, oh. No, yes.
See, I feel like my OCD kicks and I have to have a matching socks. Like, it bothers me.
I'm like immune to it.
Okay, would you rather eat a whole jar of mayonnaise or a whole tub of butter? I say butter.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, too. I was gonna say mayonnaise. Ugh.
They're both fancy.
Okay, last one. Would you rather fulfill your biggest wish or resolve your biggest regret?
I'm going with the wish.
I'm gonna go with the wish too.
Yeah.
Chandler, like, if that happened, I'm moving on.
Okay. Did you tie it?
No, you won.
Oh, I was like the second week that you won.
Yeah. We had a tie last time.
Not bad.
All right. We're gonna do Valentine's Day ideas. Get it out of here or hell yeah. So we can do a few of these. All right. A paint and sip class.
Yeah,
I'll do paint and sip class.
I will too. Yeah.
Cooking a new recipe.
Yes.
I would do that.
I'm a sucker for just like little stuff like that though. Yeah, intimate stuff. Yeah.
Stream a virtual concert. I don't like anything virtual, really.
It's not the same.
I'd rather just play music on a speaker, then.
There we go.
We could make a playlist.
There we go.
Dancing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Have a at-home trivia night.
Yes. Like just the two?
Yeah.
Or, okay.
Yeah, yeah. A chocolate tasting and truffle making date.
Like going somewhere to do it?
Yeah.
Maybe. Kind of, maybe it might be like cooking class vibes or something.
Yeah.
Making a time capsule.
Aw, that would be cute.
Yeah.
I would not do that.
Really?
Take a virtual cocktail class.
I don't like drinking.
Yeah, I'd rather take like a real one.
Get a couple's massage.
Yes, absolutely. Hell yeah.
All right. And that was kind of this or that or yes or no. Okay. So, CCC's Biz Tips with E. Let's get into these. Tips for all the bosses.
Ayo.
I'll take the camera. Last time it was all crazy.
For your segment?
I was looking crazy. Oh. And now with these braids, you know what I mean?
Yo, the show's not over yet. For my current and aspiring business owners, make sure you keep it locked to CCC's Biz Tips with E, a segment for the bosses.
You gonna make me do the beginning over because it cut it off?
Are you saying yes? I will.
She don't like it when it's
the we here at the end of the show. I'm like, no, I need to get your segment. She's like, I don't care. No, we're gonna get this.
All right. So with the minutes we have left, I want to talk about three key elements of a professional image. So it would be like tighten up for all our business owners. So your image, your professional image, it speaks volumes about you and it will help you to develop and establish a good reputation. So, you know, when people are looking at you, they determine your first impressions is within the first 7 seconds. People judge you on your appearance, your confidence, and your personality. So, in short, you want to make sure, you know, you're professional, you're positive, and you're communicating a positive vibe.
Your confidence and your personality.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, it's okay. All right. So, three key elements of a professional image include, first, your appearance. What you wear, and this wasn't a shot at Shawny. I know she thinking it is, but what you wear, how you look matters. Appearance is the first thing that people will judge you on. So, me, if I see chipped nail polish, if I see broken nails, like, I'm judging you. And that's just the way I am. Like,
when you see what?
Chipped nail polish, broken nails, unkept hair, 5 o'clock shadow, worn shoes. Like, don't try to do business with someone. Don't try to do business with someone when when you're not all together. Get yourself together, so make sure you're looking good, because your online image is important as your in-person image.
That is so true. I really broke my nail, though. Like, I broke it all the way down.
You told us. All right, so your professional behavior. So I know people, like, they straddled the line with wanting to be a professional and then wanting to be popping on social media. So for me, I would say separate your business and your personal pages for that. Like, I know some people just don't want to do it because they have more followers on their personal pages. But if you want to be doing, you know, what's the challenge? Silhouette challenge, and you want to have drunk snaps, and you make inappropriate social media posts. And I was the queen of, you know, especially at extreme parties, drunk snaps. But you can't do it if you're a business owner. There's a lot of things that I had to change when I wanted people to take me seriously. So that's another thing. And the last one is professional conduct. Do right by people. I know one time my friend, she went to a party and she brought a VIP. And the party got shut down early. And the person, you know, they didn't want to give anybody their money back, but they did give a few people that were kind of like popular in the town, like, you know, some compensation. And she was like, I will never attend one of their events again. So you got to do right by people. You want people to respect you, and you want people to respect your brand. And those are CCC's Biz Tips with E.
Hey, yo. Like, what coincidence to talk about this? And
yeah,
Chip,
no
apologies. And I literally was going to get my nails done today. I was like, oh, I don't have the time. I'll
have
to go tomorrow.
All right, so we want to thank you for joining us, Chanel.
Yes, thank
and
you.
We will be on the lookout for what's next with Shambans. And I'm going to be texting you to make sure, you know, you don't jump on another idea. Just keep going with it.
As
she
you should,
looking
right?
for it, though, too. She said as she's also should. Trying to find that yes. woman.
Yes. So just make sure, you know, you keep going.
She's like, yeah, I'm still back to you.
She's
right. All right, y'all, make sure y'all join us next week, same time, same place.
Peace. In the meantime, check out her Instagram.
Later.
And stay updated.
Yeah, yes. The model blogger.
Ayo.